Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Thank you very much. I'm blessed. I am blessed. I'm honored to be able to be the composer that was asked to do this project. I think of this really not so much as a memorial of an assassination, but more a celebration of a legacy. And when I think of composing, I don't necessarily think of melodies and rhythms so much as I think of a story. And I needed to have a story. I needed to have a connection to this man so that I could actually come up with something new, because what hasn't already been written or said about Dr. Martin Luther King? So I had to really think about what, to me, his legacy was. I made some friends in the back there just before the concert started, and we were talking about powerful music that was written during the 60s and the 50s, whether it be music about lynchings or church bombings, music like Strange Fruit, music like Alabama by John Coltrane. It's really profound pieces that were in response to the social strife we were going through. When I think of Dr. Martin Luther King, I think of hope and I think of spirituality. Throughout all of this, throughout all of the pain you suffered, whether you're black or brown, of a different belief, who you choose to share your life with. We've gone through some dark times in this country, as you know. And somehow you have to have hope through it all, right? You have to sort of find a way to have hope, a thread, something to keep you going. So you wonder, how does William Grant Still write that piece, Mother and Child, when all of the strife is going on in this country? It's something as beautiful as that. Sometimes it can be the beauty and sometimes it can be the bitterness, like a piece like Strange Fruit. So when I thought about writing this music, I thought I needed to show that this was a man that also had hope throughout it all, because he knew he wasn't going to be there to see it through, but he had to give hope to everybody he was speaking to so that they could carry the legacy. And I think that's the only charge that I could have. I don't know how the music is going to affect you. I definitely put my heart and soul into it, but I had to have a segment like the first movement, which I called Hope. The second movement is called Prayer, because of course the man was very spiritual, and I think that the music will speak to that. And at the end, Dr. Martin Luther King, that is, talks about how long will we have to wait before we get there? Not long, but how long? And that question, you know, we will fight till the end of the day, to the end of time, I think. I think people of goodwill will have to fight that until the end of time. But I think we've got a lot of people of goodwill here, and I hope that music that I've written with the help of the research by Mr. Professor Jason Miller, by the film work by Rebecca Cerese, and by this beautiful orchestra and Peter Askim, I hope that in conjunction with all that, I've done honor, justice to the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King. So I won't tell you about the piece, I'll just tell you that I hope that I have shared with you my charge to carry his legacy.
Thank you.
poor parents were brought here in 1619, against their wills, from the soils of Africa. For 244 years, they were treated as things rather than persons. They were treated as depersonalized cogs in a vast plantation machine. And even after the Emancipation Proclamation was signed by Abraham Lincoln, the Negro discovered that he was still in slavery. Because a few years later, a system came into being known as segregation, living with slavery and segregation. The Negro lost faith in himself. Many Negroes came to feel that perhaps they were inferior. This is a tragedy of the segregation. It isn't only bad because it does something to the physical body and makes for physical inconveniences, but it is bad because it does something to the soul. It gives a segregator a false sense of superiority. And it gives a segregated a false sense of inferiority. The Negro living with this system for years felt that he was inferior.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, won't you please join us as we sing one stanza of We Shall Overcome.